Welcome back. A 20-year-old engineering student from Bengaluru, Vishal, has been arrested in connection with the Bully Buy app, the app that uploaded pictures of Muslim women for a supposed auction. A woman has also been detained in Uttarakhand and will be produced in Mumbai soon. The lady whose details are awaited is said to be the main accused in the case. In fact, both the accused are known to each other and were friends on social media. The Bully Buy controversy surfaced as several Muslim women found themselves on auction on an app. Now, the app was hosted by GitHub platform and had used their photographs, many of which were doctored. What is really alarming is that a few months ago, several Muslim women found themselves similarly in an app called Suli. Despite the registration of a case in July, little progress has been made. My colleague Priyank joins us for more on this. Priyank, first of all, let's just start with the Suli app and the complete lack of progress that has been made in that case.
See, Aarti, there's been an important development which happened today with respect to the Suli app case, which was filed in the month of July 2021. That the Delhi police have finally got an approval from the Delhi government, which is of a GNCT, after the MHA had also given approval for the MLAT. So basically, since the server of these apps is based in San Francisco, the Delhi police can only get the information through the mutual legal agreement treaty, and that can be done after the due permission, which could have been given from the MHA as well. From the GNCT. So since these two important authorities have given permission for Delhi police to get information from the GitHub, tomorrow the Delhi police special cell will be moving to the court to get an official order with respect to getting information from GitHub. While talking about the second case, certainly the Mumbai police has done very tremendous progress in this case. They have not sat down and they have detained those followers who were part of this particular modus operandi. Now, the big question is that whether these suspects who have been arrested were the one who had made this app or not. Because for the benefit of obvious, let us tell them that this is an app which is being made through Microsoft software and which can be made by any person who is very well and well-versed aware about the technology. So anyone can make it, and that is a big question. But the big thing for the Mumbai police as well as Delhi police, because both of them have filed an FIR with respect to this particular Bully Buy app, is that whether they will be able to get hold of the suspect who actually made it and who had made it in the past as well.
Okay, Priyanka, thanks so much for that. Joining us this evening is RJ Saima, who's also targeted on this particular app. Good evening, Saima. Thanks so much for speaking to Mirror Now. I appreciate you really speaking up about an issue that has plagued several Muslim women for the past several months. This is not an isolated incident. In fact, worryingly, as we were hearing, this is the second incident and not much progress has really been made. There are news reports now. We have a confirmation that one 21-year-old engineering boy has been arrested. In fact, he's been produced in court a short while ago. And a woman has also been held in Uttarakhand. What is your first reaction to these arrests?
My first reaction is that I always believe where there's a will, there's a way. I really, really want to thank Mumbai Police, our Member of Parliament, Priyanka Chaturvedi, our DCP, Rashmiji, for actually following up, for giving us the confidence and hope that our law authorities will always be on the side of the citizens and not on the sides of the criminal. They, within 24 hours of registering an FIR, the case has already started looking like, you know, we will get to the root of it all. And that gives me immense hope and, immense optimism that not all is lost.
Okay, Saima, how did you find out that you were on this app? I'm sure it came as a shock to you as well, but just if you could recount, when you found out about this and your instant initial reaction.
So I think it happened on the morning of 1st of January. I was generally checking my WhatsApp messages, trying to wish people Happy New Year. And then I saw the message of a journalist friend who basically shared the list of names that was there on this obnoxious app. And that list had my name with, a lot of other names as well. And then I tried understanding what kind of an app is this. And that's when, I was told what it was like the Suli Deals app, and this one is called Bully Buy Deals app, where basically they are doing online auctioning of Muslim women and girls, calling them the maid of the day or something like that. And then a couple of them shared my pictures, morphed pictures, and how I was made like the bully buy of the deal of the day and stuff. So that's how I got to know of it. Well, was I shocked? I wasn't shocked. I wasn't shocked at all, because this has been happening. I mean, you know, these cheap tactics to silence you by morphing your pictures and spreading lies and fake news about you, or using unparliamentary words and slangs like Suli for you. I've been experiencing this for the last 4 or 5 years on social media. So I know that's their cheap tactics to silence you. And I also knew that every name out there on that list has a social media account. And these are the vocal Muslim girls and voices. So of course, it was pretty apparent that it's a communally, you know, a communal attack, and of course misogynistic. But honestly, I mean, yeah, I mean, the shocking part is that I wasn't shocked.
Yeah, because it's happened in the past. And, you know, after a while, these things become almost routine, given the fact that there is little action taken, as we've seen in the Suli case. But Saima, what is the responsibility, what is the role also of these platforms? Because right now, everything is happening after all the damage is done. But whether it is Twitter, whether it is GitHub, these platforms allow for such content to be uploaded. And then when any investigative agency actually approaches them, they stonewall these requests.
So Aarti, first I have to say this, that you know, I mean, in the world of online, I'm sure these are challenges ahead of us. But for me, the more worrying part is that our authorities and our government, why aren't they proactive in shutting these voices down, in showing these criminals their places? Why isn't legal action taken against them? I mean, in July, the first case happened, Suli Deals app case, came to light, and FIRs were registered. And why is the investigation taking so long? I don't think it's that difficult. If we can find out who that guy was who wrote such obnoxious things about Virat Kohli's daughter in a matter of hours, why is this investigation taking months? And why isn't there any breakthrough? And Mumbai police could track it down within 24 hours. So it is possible, right? And that is what is worrying. That is very unnerving. That's extremely disappointing for me as a citizen of this country.
Sure.
When the law authorities do not assure me, they do not come out and say, don't be worried, we will nab the criminals, we will nab the culprits. And I really want to take this occasion to say this, that why do we wait? Why do we wait for victims to register an FIR? When our Minister of Information and Technology tweeted that the link has been taken down, the government has instructed GitHub to take the link down, we were aware of the scandal, right? Why wouldn't the law authorities actually take notice then and there and start the investigation?
But Saima, let me just take you up on that. It is also, and tell me if you disagree, also the responsibility of these platforms to prevent, and that's a conversation that we've been having for a very long time, what is the liability of Twitter? What is the liability of Facebook for some of the stuff that is uploaded, which is misogynistic, which is racist, which is just pure bigotry? The agencies that you're talking about, of course, they have a huge role to play in cracking down on these posts, but what about these platforms as well?
Of course, absolutely, absolutely. It goes without saying that, you know, all the online platforms, they have to be responsible. They have to draw a line. They will have to have mechanisms to identify who is misusing their platform, because it cannot happen, whether it's Twitter, whether it's Facebook, whether it's other, platforms, it just can't happen. And the moment somebody notifies them, they should immediately act upon it and cooperate with all the authorities and agencies to nab the criminal minds behind it. Of course, they have to come. They are answerable, and they should be made accountable on these grounds. I totally agree with that.
Okay, Saima, just finally, I'm sure it's been a tough few days since you found out, but I'm sure there's also been an outpouring of support and, you know, kudos to you to stand up to all of this.
Aarti, I have to say this, that I've always believed that there are more and more good minds and good hearts and people who want peace around and people who want justice and truth to kind of rule. They're always mostly that, but they're silent. They need to speak up. They need to really, really, you know, love and peace and responsibility and truth and justice should make a lot of noise in today's India, because somehow it's getting clouded by hate and bigotry and all kinds of negative stuff. So I'm really thankful to every person who has, you know, raised a voice of solidarity and given me every single voice that has reached me is the voice of hope and, you know, courage. And I truly, truly value that. And it is because of their support. It is because of their solidarity that, you know, we are continuing to fight it out.
Okay, sometimes one voice is all it takes, Saima, to encourage people to speak up. And of course, silence is, you know, in some ways, it also ensures complicity, or it also ensures that these people get emboldened and they continue targeting women like you who are outspoken. Saima, thank you so much for speaking to Mirror Now. I really appreciate you taking time out.
Thank you, Aarti. Thanks a lot.